Let's create a UV sphere. S to scale, and Tab to go to edit mode. Let me show you how to select components in Blender. Click any vertices to select a vertex. Type 2 to edge select. Select any edges. Three to face select. Shift select will add more components to the selection. Click anywhere outside of the mesh to deselect, or press Alt A to deselect. Select a face, hold Ctrl, and select another face away from the original face to line select. Let's deselect, and type 1 to vertex select. Hold Alt, and select the midpoint like this to select an edge loop. Alt select this region to edge select vertically. Always press Shift Z to confirm the entire loop was properly selected afterward. The UV sphere's vertical cut will stop in the middle, because the loop won't extend beyond a triangular face. In order to select the entire vertical loop, we must press and hold Shift, Alt, and Select to select the full edge loop. Holding Alt and Shift will allow us to select any amount of meshes in any directions. Another good way of selecting components is Blender's Circle Select. C is the shortcut. We can select and drag to expand the selection. Middle click and drag to deselect, and right click to stop the tool. Let's select the edge loop in the middle, and Ctrl G to put them in a vertex group. We can see the group here. There are quite a number of tools that allow us to use the vertex group, and we can use the feature to create interesting effects. I'll show you an example with the Displace modifier. Let's select the group we've just created. Only the selected vertices were displaced. This is how the vertex group works. Let's add an interesting cloud texture. Do you see how the Displace modifier is located above the Subsurf modifier? The shape of the effect changes when we change the order in the modifiers list. Let's see what would happen if we move the Subsurf modifier to the top of the list. That looks much better. Let's apply a shiny material and animate the effect. I'll set the end frame to 50, click the display strength field, and type I as in India to set a keyframe. Let's go to line 25 to change the strength to 2, and type I to set a new keyframe. Let's go to frame 50, set the strength back to 0, and I to set a new keyframe. Let's play the animation. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.